Welcome to the session on human resource management. The topic what we are going to cover today in this presentation is about personal planning and recruiting. When we talk about personal planning and recruiting, it's all about before we could go ahead with the recruitment, what is the kind of a personal planning has to be done in the HR department and how this planning has to be executed and what is the way actually, you know, the planning has to be worked out. And what are the kind of a way actually forecasting can be done on this, and what is the exact, you know, benefit of doing that ultimately to prepare a budget and to make sure that the strategy can be worked out for a recruitment. So that's an idea behind, you know, going ahead with the personal planning and the recruitment. This is a very, you know, important kind of an activity during the beginning of the financial year. Almost many HR department and all the companies do prepare this, and they will submit this as a kind of, you know, financial value budget to the finance department. Thereby, finance department will allocate a budget for this particular purpose. So now let's try to look at what are the topics we'll be covering under this particular presentation. We'll be covering two major topics. One is, the first one is a recruitment and selection process. Essentially, it talks about, you know, how the exact planning on the recruitment and selection method has to be adapted, and recruitment sources for different kind of a job profiles and skills that we may have to adopt a different kind of a strategy. And the selection techniques, you know, has to be totally different from one position to another position. What is the overall plan has been done? That's what the first topic talks about. The second topic, which talks about how do we try to forecast the personal need. When we talk about personal need, I'm not talking about the personal aspect of it. I'm talking about HR aspect of it. Personal need. How do we identify freeze on what is the kind of a people is required, and what are the kind of a forecasting techniques can be commonly applied? That's what exactly we are going to cover in this particular presentation.